Hey, what happened? Is this one of those recloser things again?
No, that is a full outage. But the power should be coming back on soon. Remember when we installed those solar panels this summer? I don't know why the power isn't coming back though.
Hey, genius.
Yeah?
It's nighttime. Do you really think the solar panels work at night?
Oh yeah. Whoops. I guess I should have opted for that optional battery storage system when we installed the solar panels.
10 years ago, if you were putting in a system of solar panels, you likely wouldn't have considered energy storage unless you were in a unique situation where you were off-grid or had a lot of extra cash to spend. Today, energy storage is one of the most important things to consider for power systems for several reasons. First, the cost of energy storage has come down substantially. Second, the technology of energy storage systems and batteries continues to improve. And finally, our reliance on power has never been greater. And with the increased use of renewables and the application of microgrids, energy storage has a huge role in grid reliability.
In this video, we will discuss these key points and talk about various energy storage options that you should consider for your power system. Here at Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center, you can see firsthand examples of various forms of energy storage to optimize the reliability and operating cost of your system. Did you know that the largest battery in the world isn't really a battery at all, but rather a reservoir? That's right. In its simplest form, hydro storage is a lake filled with water that can be released through a hydro generator to generate electricity. Hydro storage, or pump storage as it's often called, has been used for many years and is often two lakes, one at the top of the hill and one at the bottom. Sometimes utility companies use these to offset the cost of electricity by pumping up the water up the hill at night. In other words, filling up the battery at night when the cost of electricity is cheap, maybe 3 cents per kilowatt hour, and discharging it during the day when electricity is expensive and the generated power can be sold for 12 cents a kilowatt hour. Here at the PSEC, we created this demo to illustrate a pump storage system. This lower tank is filled with water and then pumped up into the upper tank with this VFD. Once the top tank is about half full and there's sufficient head pressure on this 4-inch pipe, we release the water into the hydro generator to generate electricity, powering these two light bulbs. We can even illustrate the concept of load shedding by turning on this switch, which turns off one of the light bulbs, and you can see the effect on the other one. This simple example shows you how this storage tank acts just like a battery, like the one in your cell phone that you would fill up overnight and use during the day when you need it.
For over 150 years, lead-acid batteries have been the go-to for energy storage. If you wanted a battery to start your car, you go to the auto parts store and buy a 12-volt lead-acid battery that was rated in amp hours with a certain level of cranking amps. It would have enough capacity to do the job and would typically last about 5 years or less, recharging itself from your car's alternator. For data centers, lead-acid batteries have been the mainstay in one of two formats. Wet cells, also called flooded cells, and maintenance-free valve-regulated lead-acid, or VRLA. Wet cells are large, heavy, and take up a lot of space, but with proper maintenance, they will last 20 years. VRLA batteries are designed for a 10-year life, but for typical applications, you are lucky to get 3 to 5 years out of them. These were, and in many cases still are, the typical battery type selected for UPS backup power. As an alternate to batteries, for short-term ride-through, maybe 15 to 30 seconds or so, flywheels were used to supply power to the UPS in place of batteries. This solution relied on inertia of the flywheel being long enough to get the backup generator started for continuous power during outages. These tend to be heavy, noisy, and require a lot of maintenance over their lifetime. Today, because of widespread use in electric vehicles, there is a major shift in large bulk storage towards lithium-ion batteries and supercapacitors to replace traditional lead-acid and flywheels. So how is a lithium-ion battery different from traditional lead-acid batteries? The main differences are, of course, in the chemistry of the batteries, but from a functionality standpoint, the differences lie in the use cases and capabilities. For example, most cell phones today are lithium-ion batteries, which allow many charge-discharge cycles and allow for fast recharge times. Traditional lead-acid or other chemistries require long charge and recharge cycles, making them impractical for some applications. For large storage, lead acid was the accepted option. Not only does lithium ion chemistry increase the battery's capabilities, but with only 1/3 the size and weight of its lead acid counterpart, many new applications are possible, like hoverboards, drones, and other innovative solutions. With a 10-minute deep discharge on lead acid, it would take 10 times 10 or 100 minutes to get back to 80% charge, and 10 times that or 1,000 minutes to get back to 100% charge. With lithium ion batteries, the recharge time is only 2-to-1, and with supercapacitors, it's about 1-to-1. Since lithium ion is presently the battery of choice for electric vehicles too, the cost has come down substantially and the technology has improved dramatically. So what is a supercapacitor? Think of a supercapacitor as a rechargeable device like a battery with 100 times the power density of a battery, but used for seconds rather than minutes or hours. A supercapacitor is like a smaller storage tank with a large input valve and this larger faucet filling and draining very quickly. A battery, on the other hand, has a larger tank, but a much smaller input and output valves to fill and drain the tank. For example, in an electric vehicle, a supercapacitor is able to absorb the energy when you slam on the brakes, and a modern roller coaster uses them to shoot you out of the gate. In both cases, you only need to transfer power for seconds, not minutes or hours. As a simple comparison of cost and effectiveness, you can see that the lithium ion batteries and supercapacitors are dramatically different than the lead acid batteries and flywheels.
Now let's talk about applications of energy storage for microgrids and bulk power storage. Microgrids are standalone electrical systems consisting of multiple power sources and defined loads that can operate either connected to or independent of the primary utility grid. They provide a reliable, efficient solution to unexpected power loss, effectively balancing variations in energy demand, optimizing energy usage for more reliable power, reducing operating costs and carbon emissions. Here at the PSEC, we have a full-scale working microgrid that uses lithium-ion batteries, solar, and supercapacitors to provide alternate sources of power in addition to the normal utility and backup generator. This battery rack is 30 kilowatt hours, meaning we could supply 30 kilowatts for 1 hour or 15 kilowatts for 2 hours, for example. While this rack is fairly small, at one utility installation, we installed a 5 megawatt lithium ion battery to support an entire utility feeder during peak demands and improve reliability for unplanned outages. Bulk storage like this is becoming more popular to improve reliability and reduce cost. This rack of supercapacitors can provide about 30 kilowatts of power for 60 seconds to our microgrid, which is a great option for solar firming or transitioning to backup on traditional generator transfer switches. We also have supercapacitors here at the PSEC on one of our 93 PM UPSs for demonstrating a typical application in data centers. This is a demo of a Tesla Powerwall, which is a great option for home-based microgrids. With the Powerwall, you can use utility or solar power as sources, and if the power goes out, you can run off the lithium-ion batteries with no noise or external energy source like natural gas, compared to a traditional generator. With the Powerwall, you could use the battery as backup only, or you could use the battery for supplying power to your home at night, or use stored power from solar when the sun goes down. Or you can use a time-based discharge option to discharge the battery during peak times to optimize your utility costs. Finally, there's the storm setting when the Powerwall detects incoming storms and fully charges to provide backup power. After the storm, the system will return to its previous settings.
These innovations in energy storage and battery technology are creating new uses for the longer life and higher allowed number of charge-discharge cycles available from lithium-ion and supercapacitors. One example is found in the latest data center designs. Eaton has partnered with a large data center company and a utility company to build a solution that reconfigures conventional UPSs on the fly to be able to transfer power not only to the servers in time of need, but also back into the grid. By tying the UPS to the utility signal, the utility company tells the UPS to either consume or export energy in response to voltage changes on the grid. This action is contributing to the decarbonization of the grid by permitting a higher percentage of renewable energy sources to be installed, since the UPS is smoothing the erratic power produced by these sources, which happens when a cloud passes over or the wind stops blowing. Advancements in battery technology have also moved into electric vehicle charging systems. Here, the utility signals are tied to vehicle charging stations. This signal not only adjusts the vehicle charging rate based on grid loading, but as the battery technology improves the number of charge-discharge cycles even further, this opens the door to exporting energy, just as has been done with data center energy storage systems.
Good thing the utilities thought to have a good backup power solution.
Yeah, I think I'll go order that battery system right now.
Energy storage continues to improve and new solutions are available every day. Even with all of this change, there's still a need for low-cost bulk storage if we truly want to see grid independence and change the way we use power today.
This graphic shows where we are today with energy density for storage devices. But did you know that a gallon of gasoline provides 10 times the energy density of the best available battery technology? It's likely that the next transformational change in power systems will be related to energy storage and allow us to improve on many of the great options we already have today. To learn more about energy storage, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.